Okay, this is a tutorial that goes over how to create your logo thing. And in this project, we're going to be using Illustrator. We're not using Photoshop because Photoshop uses pixels, like a raster image. It's made up of small pixels. And to be able to print this on a t-shirt, we have to use a vector image, which is made up of, you can see here, this image here is made up of lines and shapes, so I can get as close as I want to. And it's not an I can actually place in a vector image and show you. Let's place in this. Let's see. Yeah, so I just place in one that you've actually done before. And I'll show you the difference there. When I place this in, I can zoom into it. You can see it's made up of pixels. And that's a difference because I zoom into the other one and it's made up of lines and shapes. So it can do it small. It's zooming as far as I want to. It's made up of lines and shapes. That's what the printer has to use. Okay, so let's go over and talk about what you're going to do. So we're going to go back to Canvas here. So this is part one. So part one is actually the logo you're designing. Part two is the written description. Okay, and again, part one here, you have a instructions. First off, you need to actually go and find your rough layout scan, and you're going to download that. And put that, let's say I want to use Emily's as an example. So I can double click your, you're going to find your rough layout scan. You're going to download that. And then you're going to go back to the, like, we're using Illustrator. So Adobe Illustrator right here. So you can click in the start button and Adobe Illustrator, which I have open. So I want you to click on File, New. It make it come up like this. You might look like a different. So you can click Print. It's just a preset. So you can actually tell it the logo right here, and then you're going to change it to inches, and it's going to be 5 inches by 5 inches. Okay, and then click Create. It gives you a big white square. That's fine. So I want you to hold the Alt key. It's kind of like Photoshop a little bit. Hold the Alt key and scroll the wheel on your mouse and let you zoom out. Then I want you to click File and Place, and I want you to place in that rough layout scan that you just actually saved. Same lanes, and I'll place it out here so that way I can see in the background. So if I need to, I can scroll out more and be out here. So what you need to do is you might need to each individual scan might be a little different, but most people I think use a maybe a black and white logo. It might use, so you click OK, that comes up, but you might use the skip silhouette drawing, three colors, so. You can experiment with the different tracing settings there. Okay, and then once you've, so you can see here, now this one has lines and shapes. Okay, so before I did it like this and it's made of pixels. Now I actually go up to black and white logo. I choose that okay again. And now I can see it's actually vectorized image, so it's made a vector image. So now I can expand. I right click and choose ungroup here. And now I just select on the, I just click down the gray areas, deselect it. Now click on the areas I want, don't want, and click backspace to delete them. I don't need these areas here, the black white area. I don't need the outline or the rough layout. Okay, so I just have to, so this will be option one. Option one for this logo part one. Is creating your logo from your sketch. So I can just click on that and I click on the fill color because we talked about, well, actually, Illustrator has layers, but this will, instead of foreground, background, this is actually like your inside color, which is called the fill, and the outline color, which is called the stroke. So you can change the fill colors to like maybe like a green or a blue or something like that, whatever you want to color you pair it. But if you don't like the sketch, you can actually do option two. Option two is when you go back to the internet. Let's say I'll go back to the internet. So I just find a parrot. And a lot of times using the word clip art is helpful in finding the best one. So this is actually an image. So it's not a real picture of a real parrot. So I click on images here and I go and find a picture of a parrot I want to use. So let's say I use this parrot right here. And so I just download that and I click Save Image As. and say save here. Now I can go back and to illustrate, this is option two. I'm going to go to file and place, and I go back to that parent that is found, and I place that. Okay, so this one maybe put it over here. So I have to do the same thing. This one has a lot of colors. Your logo can definitely have colors, right? And I can see this one have about six different colors here. So I can choose that. These are image tray settings. So I can choose six colors there. So, I mean, that, there's a little less colors. Maybe I want to undo that and try 16 colors here. If I want to just try that, 16 colors. That a little better job. I like that a little better. So then I want you to just click expand like you did before on group. And so now I just click on the areas that I don't want. I don't want this area. And I just, now I just click and drag over selecting everything. And I can drag it. It's too big to fit in here. If I hold the shift key, then grab the corner here and make it. If I don't hold the shift key on it, that distorts it. Have the shift key down, creates the same proportions, and I can make it whatever size and then just make it on to the image there. So the artboard is actually the image I'm saving, okay? And actually, then you go back to the canvas assignment. So we need to go back and add the register symbol. It's required to add in the register symbol. So you click on that. It's going to be a register symbol. You're going to download it just like you did your rough layout scan. I'm going to go back to Illustrator. I'm going to click File, Place, and then I'm going to define register symbol. I'm going to place it here. I'm going to actually then click black and white logo again. Then I'm going to click Expand. Then ungroup, and then I click on the areas I don't want, which I need only whites areas, and then I need to click on both of these things, and I click on the shift key, and I make it smaller, right? So I don't want to distort it. I want to hold the shift key to keep it certain proportions, and so I'll just zoom out here, move this where it needs to go. The zoom is actually really super important, being able to zoom, holding Alt key and scrolling up the edge of your mouse. That's the best, easiest way I know to zoom. I found a zoom using the Control Plus. We learned those different ways to zoom. You can do this one of those other ways. That's fine. It's still a little bit big, so I'm going to make it a little bit smaller here. Okay. Now I can zoom out, zoom back in. And if I wanted to like add some text in there, maybe make a, maybe it's a restaurant or something like that, then I can add some text there. Click here and I can hit, maybe I want to make it two lines here. Here it results. Okay, and then I'm going to actually highlight the text there. Say I want it to be a little larger here. Say about like, this one here, I can, this is just center alignment here if I want to do that, and then I can actually make it whatever font I want. Let's say I like this one right here. Pair results here. Click on that selection tool, and then I can make it sort of up here. Okay, now I've got my logo. Okay. So I actually did it option two, but you can definitely stay with option one if you want to, okay? But definitely make sure that your logo is not just an image there, but it needs to communicate your ideas with maybe some text. It's pretty much a good way to kind of make sure, okay? And then you finish that, you click on file and save as. You name it in your idea folder, like mine has my initials. And then just name it as logo like we did before. It needs to be Illustrator. You'll have to change the file type. So click on save and then okay. And then we need to go back to canvas here. And this canvas here. And I click on turn in. And I click upload. I click choose. And I've just got my logo up here. I need to, if I need to go back to my ID folder, that's fine. Click on logo, open, and then submit again. And that finishes this tutorial.